Вы знаете, очень многие вещи, многие идеи,
you know,
many
useful ideas and tips somehow devalue to such an extent that nothing is left of them. Moreover, they turn into the opposite. So confession is one of the sacraments of the Orthodox Church. And we can see that sometimes attitudes to confession differ a lot. So the teaching of the Church is that there is no sacrament and no use if a person takes it without faith and without a firm promise to change their life and without repentance. Without this, a sacrament can turn against this person. Apostle Paul says about communion, for he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself. Moreover, he says, for this reason, and it was the first century, for this reason many are weak and sick among you, and many sleep, meaning they die. So the reason is as follows: if you truly believe that indeed this is the blood and body of Jesus Christ, you must take it with awe and fear of God, and moreover, when you take it, you must promise to God that you will try as hard as you can not to do the same thing again. So there is no sacrament where there is no sincere repentance and inner promise to try not to repeat those bad things I did before. So this is true about all the sacraments, including the confession. And indeed, we can turn it into some list, or as I often say, report of the sins committed. And I will read it to the priest, or the priest can read it, but what use will that bring to anyone? Even if I come to the priest and just tell my sins, I can set you a simple example. For example, if a demon came and enumerated all his sins, what use would that be to him? That would be no use. So confession is for our soul to get healed of all the dirt and sins that we committed. Sins are wounds, and we must clear ourselves. We must get healed, and that is only possible if we sincerely repent and promise to God not to do that anymore. And so, if we have just a formal approach to any sacrament, like confession, communion, marriage, and so on, just a formal approach gives a person no God's grace. So it's terrible that we don't understand it anymore, that we believe that the main thing is just to take communion or to go to confession. So we pay attention just to the form and we throw away the essence, the meaning of this sacrament. And the meaning is that all the sacraments will heal our souls only if we come with the sincere repentance and with the sincere promise not to do the same thing all over again. In this case, indeed, confession heals a person and gives them great power. Many people feel that a burden was taken off them after confession, and quite often a confession turns into some kind of a progress report of the sins committed. Especially it's terrible when a person comes with some huge list and starts reading without understanding that we can never enumerate all the sins that we commit, and anything we say is just one drop in the ocean. The bottom line is that right now I must repent in front of God, and I must tell the priest something that hurts my soul so much that I can never forget it. There is no reason for me to put it down. Sometimes there are exceptions when it's the first time for someone, the first confession, and there are things that a person is afraid of forgetting. Then it is clear. But when a person goes to church on the regular basis, these lists are absolutely unnecessary. And if I don't feel pain because of my sins and I'm afraid of forgetting them, then there is no use in enumerating my sins. As a result, sometimes sacraments are regarded as some magic actions. So the main thing is to baptize someone, regardless of whether they believe or not. So the form becomes more important than the meaning of a sacrament, than Jesus Christ Himself. That's a tragedy. And one of its important elements is that our prayer has been turned into some form. So there is just a service reading the prayers, but who is praying? And if someone is praying, what are they praying for? They're just praying to get rid of some earthly problems. But who prays, "Lord, forgive me, I lied again"? So we must remember about the right prayer, and Saint Ignatius Brenchaninov says that we must learn to pray, and he says that there is no prayer without awe, without repentance and concentration. He says it is empty, it is dead, it is even offensive to God. So that's the same attitude we have towards prayer and sacraments. So if we pray, the only thing we pray for is that our children have no problems and so on. So it turns out that we are classic materialists, and holy fathers say that we mustn't turn to the Lord of Lords with some negligible prayers, because He might get offended, and that's the only thing we are praying for. So we forgot about the correct prayer. with concentration, awe, and repentance. And only this prayer is the real prayer which will do good to all of us. And in this case, a person comes to confession with the state of a soul which allows God to clean his soul, because without true repentance, God cannot do anything by force.